Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Now, the chances are, if you're interested in astronomy, you also have an interest in the weather. So today we're going to have a look at a weather station. This particular model is the Bresser 5-in-1 weather centre, and we're going to open it up, put it together and see how it performs. So inside the box you've got a set of instructions which are pretty comprehensive, and I'd say they're reasonably easy to follow. You have a unit that you place inside your house, which gives you the readout of the data from the weather station, and we'll come back to that later. And then you have the main weather station itself, which comes in one big lump, so there isn't anything to assemble. It looks quite substantial, but it actually only weighs just over 600 grams. And the only other thing you've got to work out is how to mount this unit. Now, you obviously want to mount it vertically, and you want to mount it so that the wind direction is accurate. And to do that, on top of the unit, there's an N basically telling you to mount this, pointing it in a north direction. In order to mount it, you've got a couple of options. It comes with a bracket here, which can clamp onto a post maybe you have. And then the foot on the bottom of the weather station can either be orientated in this way to mount on top of a post, or it can be rotated in order to be clamped on the other side of a post, with this being the other part of the clamping device. So you've got a couple of options. Other than that, you've just got to put batteries into the two units. So we'll do that and we'll see how it performs. Okay, so what functions have we got? So starting at the top, we've got a display of the current time, and it's got a radio connection to pick that up. We've got the day and the date and an indication of the phase of the moon. And then in this area here, we've got the indoor humidity and the outdoor humidity coming in from the weather station, this one. Against the indoor humidity, there's a little smiley face or sad face telling you if it's a comfortable range of humidity or not. Over here we have the temperature, both indoors where this receiver unit is and outdoors where the weather station is. And here we have a symbol that tells you a prediction for the next 12 hours. There's an algorithm inside here which is predicting what the weather is going to be like for the next 12 hours. And then down here we've got an indication of the barometric pressure. And this is a history graph which is telling you the trend of that barometric pressure. We'll have another look at that in a moment. Over here we have an indication of the wind direction. So this is coming in from the weather station as the weather vane turns around in the wind, and it's telling you in this case that the wind is south-southwest. Then there's a measurement of the wind speed and an indication of whether that's light, moderate, strong, etc. And then there's a Beaufort scale where that value is put against the Beaufort scale. So in this case, it's very light winds, 1.8 miles per hour and Beaufort scale of 1. And then finally, down in the corner, there's an indication of wind chill. Now, down at the bottom of the panel, you've got a series of buttons, and these show you some of the additional features of the weather station. So working from the left to the right, there's a history button. If you press that, it will tell you the values of the data we've just looked at every hour. So you can step back and you look at the maximum minimum values that were taken in that hour. So it's quite a useful function. And then if you leave it, it'll reset after a few seconds back to the current data. You also have a max and min, which is steps you through the parameters one by one and shows you the maximum minimum values that it has stored since the unit was last reset. And you can see if you leave it running for quite a while, you get a good range of data for each of the parameters, temperature, humidity, etc. And again, if you leave the button unpressed, it resets back to the current data. Over here, we've got four buttons that allow you to show more data for various functions. So the first one here is showing you about rainfall. So if we press that, then this area is configured to tell you about rainfall. And then it can, if you press it again, you can see there's been 41.2 millimeters of rain since I set the unit up. And you can toggle through to see the rain in the last hour, day, or week, and that's month. So that's pretty clever. And you get a little graph of that data as well, so you can see the trend. The next button tells you about the forecast weather, and as you press that, it toggles through various displays of barometric pressure in different units. And again, as a trend, you can see if the pressure is rising or falling. The next one is about wind, and it allows you to toggle between average wind speed and the strongest gust that's been detected. And then finally, you can toggle this area down in the bottom to show you either heat index, indoor dew point, or the wind chill. So the temperature outside, taking into account the value of the wind, but because there's very little wind right now, it's the same value. Okay, so you might ask, is the data accurate? Well, I'm not able to check all of the values, but for a couple of them, I can get an idea. So the indoor temperature, that compares accurately to other thermometers I've got inside the house. And for the barometric pressure, again, I've got a barometer, and the values are in good alignment. You can set the unit up to have a reference barometric pressure to allow for the altitude of where it's situated. Other than that, the wind direction seems pretty accurate, but I say the wind speed, probably you need to have quite an exposed spot for the wind meter to work accurately. I've got a small garden, and probably the values I've seen don't reflect the full strength of the wind because of the effect of trees and fences and things like that. So other than that, I'd say that all the data seems to have good correlation to the weather forecast you see on the news and data that you can compare sources. So final thoughts, I'd say it's a nicely thought out weather station, quite easy to use. The instructions are clear, although there's quite a lot of options to set wind speed in miles per hour or in knots, etc., etc., set your barometric altitude. So there's a little bit of configuring to do once you've got the unit, when you first get the unit set up. But it's got a lot of capability. It's got some nice functions, like it's got a backlight, which comes on for a few seconds. You could also use the unit as an alarm clock if you wish. And overall, I'd say it's easy to use, gives you a lot of information, and as far as I can judge, things like the history function and the weather forecast seems to correlate well with the weather I can see out of the window. So Bresser 5-in-1 weather center seems to be a good piece of kit. Okay, thanks for watching.